Okay. I think we're up. I think we are up. Why the fuck am I doing it at this time of night? I don't know. I'm doing this at such a dumb time at night. But anyways, so this is just gonna be a late night analysis. It's gonna be me versus Titus from Waddle West, which, as a recording of this, happened earlier today. Main things I really want to go over are just what kind of where can my execution be polished up. What habits do I still have regardless of controller? How to handle Falco lasers, specifically in the corner. How to handle Falco mix-ups, and what to do when Falco camps or slows down the pace slash tempo. I thought I played pretty well this set. It's still pretty fresh in my mind, so my mind, it may change over time if I look back at the set maybe a few days from now, but I thought I played pretty well. Execution, not quite where I want it to be, but I can see a big indicator of where my habits aren't the greatest on box yet, or like my habits are still carry over from controller to box. There's still some things I do where it's like, regardless of what type of controller I pick up, these things will still be there for better or for worse. So that will be the main thing I really want to highlight. So we'll see what happens when we get into it. Let's see. Battlefield, I don't mind. I don't mind this pick at all. I think it's a pretty decent pick for the matchup. Yeah. I just got caught. I got caught in my movement there. Missed an L cancel and got caught. Okay, hang on. Go back. Okay, there's really no reason for me to run up shield this early. They go back right here. What is Falco's threat here? Especially if he's buffering a roll. There is actually no threat in this situation, since he's already committed to roll, and putting up shield is a one frame window, so yeah, wait, did his shield, was he in lag already here from something? He was in lag from forward air downer, it seems like. So I'm dashing back. Wow, okay, so I'm already charging in. There's literally no reason for me. And it goes back to something Bob Money told me years ago. And I mean years ago, where it's totally fine to just run up and just eat the hit. You don't need to shield at this low percent, especially if I'm at like 8%. Just like, don't shield at low percents. Yeah, there's literally no reason. I'm gonna type this out real quick in notes for. Because, I mean, there's not really any threat. If I get back aired, sure. Like, there's only one for sure certain move that presents any sort of threat here. Every other move here is kind of a non-threatening situation. Like, you'd have to either down air or shine me to get any sort of thing out of it. Let's see. I don't even dash chance this. I haven't really represented dash chance much. I just dash in, grab. Okay. Right here. This is fine. The grab is fine. But this early on, it could be a flub, but also could be not. There's no reason for me to ever commit to, even if it was a flub and meant to be a short hop knee, this early on, like, you want to hit them early with the tech chases to really put, like, the threat in them that you're not afraid to rely on the RTC to do something. And if it stops working, then you can start to adjust and apply for some of those reads. Like, it's kind of a reverse engineering of the bomb money, where you want to rep, like, the read first. I think it's fine to go for the read maybe once early on, but it'd be worth keeping this in mind later, see if I do it again. Run up shield. Okay, that was a good one. That was a good time to do run up shield. Because look at the percent, and it's a timing mix-up also. That's the other thing that's really good. The run-up shield, timing mix-up. If I do that maybe out of a dash chance, or say I do that, just run up and then there, it changes the rhythm a little bit. Econom. Flub the RTC. Good roll. Okay, that is going to be something to keep in mind, because now it's gotten predictable. So, good roll, this is fine. Second time I've done that, so I've run up shield and I nair. Obviously a power, like, I was probably looking for a power shield, but I want to keep knowing this later on, because I do this nair a ton. And I've noticed I get punished for it a lot, so alright, just don't live and die by the fade in there out of shield. Because I am very self-aware that I do this nair a lot, like, probably more than I'd like to. It really has won me a lot of games and got me a lot of very, very clutch combos or out-of-jail-free situations. But people are getting better now to where they generally sniff that out. That's, like, one of the first options they're ready to cover. They're just like, they wait and CC it, or in this case for Titus, he just fires the gun. Fires the gun to jumble up my movement. So it's one Fabian. Yep, he just fires a laser because what can I do out of that? I mean, I have to be like frame perfect or be ready to jump, double jump out of the laser stun. And that's like next level type of shit. And I mean, I probably can do that as like a bait, but maybe not at this close of a distance. Like, even if I try to double jump out of this, I probably get clipped by the up tilt. So that's kind of like going to be one of like the inner kind of metagame stuff I want to look at. And this also just goes back to what I said, the number two thing I said, which is what habits do I still have regardless of the controller? This is one of them. This is 1,000% one of the situations where I certainly just, I still have that habit. I still have that habit. And it's just going to be something I'm going to just have to adapt and just like master as time goes on. Is just know that, okay, regardless of controller, I still do these things. And it's important to be aware of it. I like this LUD refresh and install. Great air dodge recovery. Let's go back real quick. So, get caught. This is fine. It's a good stall. Man, it's tiring. I'm tired. This is a good stall. This is fine. It's a bit risky. Right here. Unfortunately, I won the trade. If I lost the trade, I'd probably get knocked right back off stage. If I either get traded or lose the trade, either just land right back on. But won the exchange. That's fine. Gets myself back to center. Kind of just pretty solid gameplay for the most part. Nothing really crazy of note yet. Good legendary. He's not CCing. Or did Titus jump? No, he just didn't CC. Okay. Right here. Ah, that's just an unfortunate trade. I love the air dodge recovery. This is something I will say. I don't think I do this if I'm on controller. For whatever reason, I tend to just neglected air dodge recovery so much, actually. When I was starting out, I don't know if it's because of the way box works now or what, but I see myself doing this way more than I ever did on controller. Like, maybe it's just because I'm learning it for the first time. I knew this was something that I should learn or neglect, but either way, I'm really happy at the fact that I'm air dodge recovering now, because it leads to time mix-ups like this. Like, he was like, if this was up B, I'd be dangering way smaller, like way slower down. I'd be going like kind of like this, or air dodge, I'd just be dropping down like that. It creates such a tricky mix up, and it's like, even though Falcon has probably one of the more predictable recoveries in melee, there's still some tricks like the air dodge that can get you some mileage, and that was definitely an instance there. Legendaire, could I have gotten something out of this? Get the Nair. Here's the thing. Falco tech roll away is really difficult to cover a lot of times. Like, I've seen players, what they do, they will, they'll like RTC Nair, RTC up air. I could maybe have done that. He may have been too far out of reach for me to do it. Yeah, he was way too far out of reach. Yeah, actually, this was fine. Like, this is way too far for me to do by anything, because He could have either like shined me. I could have maybe run up shield and done something if he up tilted. But that's like so like situational, like 40 chest brain type of move. So like this is a decent range to be at. Maybe like a little bit closer, maybe like here. Because with this type of rage right here, Falco is actually pretty safe. Falco's pretty safe here. There's not really much I can do. Like, if he does a laser or like any sort of like aerial that isn't down air, I could maybe 4B him, but that's like a crazy commitment to do to like catch them. And plus, also, if I miss, I just die. I go down there. So, like, pretty much like he can either, like, Tyus here can either just go to ledge and just be safe there and chill because. Get double laser here is actually really safe also. Like only Saibi really is a threat to it. Unless he fades really, really far in, I can down tilt it. But for the most part, it's pretty safe. Like Falco, I wouldn't say he has the advantage here, but he definitely is a lot safer than you think. Like it's just not like there's a ton of room for him to work with, even with this type of space. Good recognition by me. Good defense. Clipped him. Ah, I messed up. I could have. Can I have. I do like a change of movement here. 1-2. Nice. Could I have. This is where I need to probably like act out a way quicker. Yeah, I need to act out way quicker because that could have been like knee or soft knee up air. That's definitely like a. That could be like a stock swing, basically. I'll add that to the list. It's a pretty simple one, but it's incredibly important. Catch a poke. Okay. So I catch with the poke while invincible. Could I have. Yeah, this is with the startup here. I could maybe run off up air, and I think I just gave him full respect instead of trying to. Let's hypothetically think about this real quick. So, I mean, wait here, he's in Firebird, so. In Firebird, now he's in wait. Alright, so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43. So 43, let's go to frame data real quick and let's see. Let's go to melee frame data on Firebird. So we're gonna look at this and yep, frame 43 is correct. And when does Falcon up air start? Falcon up air starts to say, I basically have like the amount of frames that I had to work in this situation is absurd. Like, this is easily run off up air ball. Like, easily run off up air ball. That's definitely a missed opportunity by me because let's take it back real quick and let's see. So, poked. Yeah, this is just, I literally can just run off and jump up there and he's dead. Like, straight up. And even, like, if I even, like, don't even have it up, don't even think that's precise enough. I have 14 frames on knee. So even then, I could beat it out. So, I mean, this is actually a drop by me in this scenario. Because I could just dash and get to him in time, probably. And even then, if the Firebird comes out, my Epric probably could be quick enough to beat him. So, big drop on my part. And then let's see when he snaps to ledge here. So he snaps and does get up double laser. At this range, wait. What? Snaps and jumps. I don't think the down tilt is bad here. He did the laser really high. And did he do a low one? He tried doing a low one, but he mistimed it. This is definitely an instance of I can easily just get over there. Probably an instance where I can get over there in time and just do something. Like, that's me just not being mindful of my spacing. Because, I mean, this down tilt, actually, that down tilt didn't whiff by much. It did not whiff. How big is down tilt? Let's see. I'm curious now. That didn't miss by too much. It's about like here. I didn't miss by too much. It's not a bad decision to do this, honestly. Like that wasn't the worst. That wasn't the worst decision in the world to try that, but just something to keep in mind probably. Get grabbed. What I do? I'll try to get lasered. I conditioned to shield. That's not good. That's actually a habit I need to stop. Don't try to overcorrect the shield after you get hit by a laser. Write that down. So, yeah, because I just think about the next interaction. I tend to, now thinking about this, don't overcorrect at your laser hit. Because pretty much a lot of times, correct. A lot of times I notice is that I like to overcorrect the situation. And almost like maybe it's too much of like an ego sense. I'll try to like be like, yeah, I am able to do this interaction. And rather than, I should not try to overcorrect this scenario and like tell them laser me again and see what happens. I just have to go to the next interaction of what's next. And yeah, melee's a fast game. I probably meant to power shield it. That's just not what happened. Because my shield is up. I get hit and my shield's up now. So let's think hypothetically here before he grabs me. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'll probably try rolling here, I think. But about 17 to 18 frames. That's a good enough time where I could probably dash out in time, dash out a laser stun, and get out of that situation. This is sort of the laser thing I was talking about. This is way too linear. Way too linear by me. Right here. This actually is a pretty good laser. But again, I get hit and I land. He's shielding right now, so I get hit. This is fine. I'm in landing lag and I instantly put up the shield. Like there's no reason really for me to put up the shield when he get his shield up. He could just laser shine me here, actually, now thinking about it. He actually could just laser shine me and really get some damage on. Or, like, even just, like, laser up tilt. Like, any sort of thing other than laser shield, like, he kind of left himself open to where I can do something about it in this ordeal. Because he puts up his shield now. Like, I'm already shielding. Like, I'm kind of already panicking. And, again, it's another instance where I don't need a shield. I'm at 12%. What's 12% going to do to me, aside from a down air or a shine? There's not really much of a threat otherwise. Like, he has to commit to those moves, because that's... And then up tilt, because those are his biggest rewards. Other than that, there's no reason to, because I can at least CC the up tilts for a decent percent. I'm definitely in CC range at this percent. But... It's not as, again, it's not as threatening as you think it would be, especially at the range I'm at. Like, he'd have to, like, dash in or walk in a little bit to get the shine to catch me. Grab. A little desperate. There's no real reason for me to dash back here. Because he throws. Yeah, he dashes back, and then this is fine. He dashes back again. Yeah, I dash back. Yeah, He's dashing back almost every time I think he lasers or does a move, so let's look at this again. Up throw. Yeah, he's like, is Falco dashing back after an aerial or laser? I think it's actually a very good question to ask now thinking about it, because Let's look at this trend, the entire stock. Dash back. Dash back. It's similar to the Marth roll, actually. Let's play back actually the beginning of the stock. I want to see how much dash backs we see. One. Two, three. Kind of a four. Five, maybe a six. Okay, and that stock alone, he did it 5 to 6 times. And let's see here. Yep, 7, 8. Nine. Okay, in the span of one stock he did it 9 times. He did it about 8 to 9 times where he dashed back and then lasered. Is Falco dashing back into laser? Actually, that'd be a better explanation for this. Ten. Eleven. Twelve. That's like kind of a 13. Okay, so in two stocks, he's already done it 12 to 13 times, so. Sorry, I have like a sneeze on the verge of my nose. This can be like the biggest thing to like keep note of is just dash back laser. Oops. Fine. A little desperate, trying to grab, that's fine. Wait. So I get his stock. This is fine. What did I do after this laser? Was I hit while jumping? Yeah, I was. Let's see. Good CC. What did I do after this? Did I try grabbing? I did. Okay. That explains it. I don't fault this option, but I definitely just need to be more cognizant that there is the possibility that I get shined at this close of range just because of frame advantage. Because Falco has all the frame advantage here, pretty much like he has all the time in the world. That's just it's not the best. That's been going good. It's been pretty good now. Pretty good analysis. Mainly just like it's kind of a lowbrow analysis because I'm just like kind of just seeing things how I see it right now. It's still pretty fresh in my mind, but I really want to just like get this set down to study, just like just get it through my mind, get it through my system, and also good discipline. But it's going pretty solid. This is just this is kind of an easy grab. Just not the best grab. Just I think it goes back to like it's kind of like a show grab adverse thing Wizzy told me about. Yeah. It's just like I don't know, it's just good discipline really. I'm trying to do this more now that I'm on box. I think just it's honestly just better to stay maybe stay in shield here. It's like a coulda woulda shoulda. I know like Wizzy likes to go for this a lot, and I've been trying to do it more and I've gotten some reward off of it. It's kind of like a risk reward sort of deal. It's like you have to accept the risk that there is a possibility that you're gonna get shined here. And it kind of puts more of the pressure on the opponent to where if they're gonna do something at this close of range that isn't shine or something that can beat out my grab, because let's look at my grab startup real quick. My grab startup is where is it? Where is it? Yeah. So my standing grab is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it comes out on frame 7. Now let's think about this real quick. In this time, so he's in back air lag right now from an elk cancel now. So he lands there. That's frame 1. Now let's go to Falco real quick. There it is. No, I want to just. There it is. That how you do it? Okay, there it is. So let's go to my grab, which comes out frame 7. And Falco is coming down with back air right here. So when L canceled, it's 10 frames. So let's think about this in hindsight. Comes down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so he comes out, and then what is my grab start on? It's on 1, 2, 3. Okay, so on frame 3, so it beat it out by like it beat it out by 4 frames. What could I have done instead? I could have actually jumped and maybe gotten out of this, but that's like frame, that's literally frame perfect for me to jump, and even then I think I would have still gotten caught. So I think it's probably better just to stay in shield or roll to get out of this situation. But if he if Falco does anything else, I'm curious actually of his frame data now of what he could have done, because he obviously couldn't have jumped and done anything. If he jumps and does anything, he loses because he does, has a 5 frame jump squat. So he's kind of fucked. He's kind of fucked here if he jumps. That's it's a bad spot. Same thing with specials. He can't really do anything out of it except shine. Shine's literally the only thing that's his saving grace here. So we have to pretty much go to what was it? His tilts. I'm stupid. He could maybe jab. That'd be two. That's 2 to 3 frames. So that could beat it out in time, but then it becomes a game of am I ASDIing it down? Am I ASDIing down slash holding CC? And then same there, same here. Fordo can beat it out. I think I forgot the how many frames turnaround is. I have to look into that. Up tilt, same thing. He could have maybe up tilted me and been fine. So, and then same with dash attack. So he does actually have some options here. Shine was easily the best one, the best option. It was shine and jab. I think those are his best options because if I try jumping, I just lose. I get caught in the air. I get stuck in the air. So that's fine. That's really good that he did that or shine or yeah. So like he has like roughly 3 options here. Unless we count, nah, we don't really count jab too. That'd be too, I think too close or too slow. But yeah, rough spot. This is kind of a rough spot. It's better if I should have just stayed in shield here. So I got Doesn't finish that well. Run up shield. Okay, this is a time. Okay. The difference. Run up shield's fine here at this high percent. I don't mind this at all. And again, it's been working. Maybe it's also just by virtue of me trying to power shield and just fucking up. So it has its benefits. But run up shield's good. I'm changing the timing and I'm kind of just clipping them little by little. See, could I hold down here? Yeah, I could have maybe held down here. Did I jump? Yeah, I could have just held down here. Run up shield when it's bad. Can't be too cautious with it. Like, I just gotta go and fucking grab him, especially if he's stuck in shine like this. I just gotta run up grab him. Plain simple. That's me playing a little bit scared and maybe a bit too habitual. I find myself doing this, at least against Falco, I do this a lot. I still do this, I think, against every character in some capacity. I tend to habitually just run up shield just to disrupt their spacing. Like, I just run up shield to run up shield. I don't do it with a purpose. Like, I can't just preemptively anticipate the run up shield and everything, especially if they make a flub. Like, if they make a flub, I gotta capitalize on it. I can't just be habitual and just be like, oh, I just run up shield. That's just not how it works. I gotta just be more cognizant of that. Again, that just goes back to, again, the box ha or the any controller habit. I just don't have was it? It goes back to the any controller habit, where it doesn't matter what controller I do, I still have this habit. It's same thing with an air habit. Don't just run up shield to run up. Don't just run up shield. Yeah, don't just run up shield to run up shield. Like, there's no reason for me to just do it just to do it. Because what's the purpose behind run up shield? There's got to be a purpose behind it. I don't see any sort of purpose behind this run up shield, really. Like, yeah, there's literally no reason to. I could just dash grab him here. I literally could just dash grab him out of this shit. So yeah. Don't. I have my notebook. In case you're wondering, I have my notebook right by me, and I'm just writing this down. Writing this down. Run up shield just to run up shield. Gotta have a purpose behind it. So I get got. What'd I do here instead? Did I try grabbing him? I think I'm pretty sure I did. Yeah, I tried jumping. That's a jump squat there. I tried doing an aerial or something, probably. Two. That's good. Nice. Oh, don't mind it. Don't mind it. Two. That's good. Did I jump out of this? I'm trying to be like really like nitpicky when it comes to. Okay, I was jumped. I jumped. Okay, in this situation here, this is where I think I'm gonna need to start learning to use the modifiers better, because I could just forward tilt this, like straight up. Like Falco actually, I think beats me to jump squat here. Okay, we jump at the same time, but still. If I had dropped shield here and. Let's hypothetically think about this real quick. If I were. So when does Falco jump squat start? It starts right here. So this is frame one. If I were to hypothetically forward tilt him here. That's 9 frames. And when does laser startup happen? Laser startup starts at 23. So I just win this 100%. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, okay, so he's in jump there. Let's just think hypothetically here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, 9. 10, 11. Yeah, I literally just if I four tilt him here, he probably gets knocked off stage, hypothetically. So this is like probably a situation where I just need to take note of where my range is. This is something I'm really good at, actually. I was really good at being aware of on controller, and I think I'm just gonna need to relearn it. I don't have my tech skill quite down yet, but this is probably something where use modifier F tilts. Because there is a. Because there are some uses for forward tilt that a lot of people don't know about S Falcon. Like you could beat up Blazer Star up with this thing pretty easily. And then also you could beat like Peach low float with this. Like it's actually pretty useful to just go and throw out a tilt here. Hold down. Okay. Even though I died here, I really like tanking a laser and then jumping out a laser stun. I really like doing it. Sometimes what I've done in the past is I would intentionally Falcon kick into the laser and then jump because I get my jump back. And I've actually experimented with this on Uncle Punch where when you hear like when Falcon yells Falcon kick, when he does like the k when he says kick, that's when he gets his jump back actually. And I don't know if a lot of people know about that, but it's a small audio cue to like take note of that. That's when he gets his jump back. Actually, I'm really curious. I don't know if anyone's ever really done any sort of like frame data on that because I think it'd be a really interesting experiment to do aerial Falcon kick and figure out the exact frame on when you get your jump back. And I think a good experiment actually is just a laser Falcon and see what happens. Because I've been able to get my jump back by doing that, and I've messed around. It's like around the K range, which it's a bit of an audio cue, but now I'm really curious to look at the frame data of that sometime on Uncle Punch and figure out when exactly he gets his second jump back. Oops, that's a flub. Actually, pretty good gameplay here. Like, none of this is actually that bad at all. Good de defense. Get caught by lasers, that's fine. I'm avoiding it. Dash chant. Okay, that's good. Good shield. Oh. Maybe stomp out a shield, but what did he do instead? He would have been ready. He would have been ready to probably down air me afterwards. This is kind of a risky deal if I were to try it. I think I did try it here. Okay, I definitely did try to stomp out a shield this. I just got full hop instead, but may I actually worked out for the better. Let's see, run off. This is fine. I did not take into account his role here. Don't know how intentional it is, but Either way, I gotta just start conditioning Wizzy's Dot more, especially if I like hit their shield. At least like put the fear in them that I gotta like put the fear in them that I can rep this stomp after you do after I do an aerial on your shield. Because usually what I've done in the past is I kind of condition for the grab or condition for the aerial rather than condition for the roll, especially like this close. Like I think it's okay to represent every once in a while like a run off back air and then into that, because I kind of just because he's facing away in this situation here. He's facing away on my shield, and realistically speaking, at this range, what can Falco really do out of shield held here that can be dangerous? Like really, like there really isn't a lot that Falco can do here. Like Shinar's shield misses completely. Nair's shield and down arrow shield got pretty much have nothing. He'd have to like get like basically max drift down arrow shield to even clip me in this situation. Like you factor in that I'm basically, do I dash back here? I do, and I even have a couple frames. He could way dash back Shine. That's definitely something he can do. And let's look at the frames actually and see. If this would have to be like a max range. This would have to be like a max range way dash back Shine. So let's, because we have to factor in jump squat here. So he's got a 5-frame jump squat and then his Shine's frame one. So he could probably do way dash back Shine, but that'd be, yeah, it, but it'd be really precise. Like it definitely would be like a really precise input to do. Yeah, probably not. I think it's still worth keeping in mind that, but I think realistically speaking, what you mentioned, Fallen, this is probably like, I think way dash back Shine is probably the best option that out of this whole entire scenario, because but I mean he can maybe back air, maybe like it has to be way dash back Shine here. You would have done back air is what you're saying, Fallen. Way dash back Shine, turn around, grab is my plan there. Okay. And that makes sense, because in a worst case scenario, if you do, like if the say if I shield the Shine or some shit like that, you still have the threat range because you can just Shine grab, which I think is a pretty good threat range. Especially, I think Shine grab is just something players just don't do a whole lot at like the mid to high level. Only really at top level, I think I see it done a lot more. So I think it's probably like the best bet in this entire situation, because I cover everything else. And actually, now thinking about this, Stomp actually just would have been just the best option altogether here on my end. Because even if Titus were to do this way dash back Shine, Stomp has like the cannon, I call it the cannonball effect, where Falcon does down air. Here it is. So we're gonna go through his frames here. Yeah, he's in like this sort of frame. So from about frame, it really from like frame 3 to about frame 13 or 14. Yeah, exactly. It's Stomp is incredibly good. If Falcon basically has this 10 frame window where he's in this cannonball state, which is a lot. That's a sixth of a second that he's in this sort of cannonball state. And it's insanely good. And not even to mention the fucking range that this thing has. That's the other thing. I mean, this is ma frame 17 is literally max range stomp. Like, because if I stomp that, like, Titus gets popped up and we start a check chase and go to town. So see. This is fine. He's still doing the, like, I noticed he's still doing the dashback. He's still doing dashback laser. I think it's like the 13th or 14th time he's at this game. 14, 15, yeah. That's like all he does. Like, he loves, like, that's a big habit log on Titus. I'm going to write this in my personal notebook. Just Titus loves dash back laser. He's done it like almost every game, like every interaction on the stocks. Like, it's a pretty predictable habit to take note of. Ooh. Actually, pretty decent move in here. Let's see. Did I just contest it wrong and just get clipped? Oh, that barely missed. Oh, that barely missed. That sucks. That sucks. Actually, that wasn't a bad error whatsoever. It's just, I just got beat. But no harm, no foul. Good dash back. Nice. Acta laser stone here. This is good. I need more of this. This is something, like, I there's no need to shield. There's no need to shield. And look what happens when you don't shield. You just get the fuck out of there. You get the fuck out of the situation. It's not there. You're at disadvantage here. Don't contest and mess with it. Just got to hold down here. This is a little things like this. Like, that's me just being way too preemptive. This scenario. In fact, actually, even if I stomp this, I'd be fine, actually. I just think it was the wrong decision to knee. Because if I stomp this, I get over a gap attack, actually. Because stomp, actually, go back. It goes back to cannonball state again. Where, when does this gap attack come out? Like, I get it. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God, dude. I literally can just avoid this entirely with stomp. So, like, literally, Titus gets stomped and popped up and kneed here if I do that instead. So I just made the wrong decision. Nair. Nice. Okay. I like this again. I don't. In the past me. I mean, I could have Nair need this potentially, but I like my pickup afterwards. I do not do this enough. I pointed this out in the last analysis I did with me versus Catbot on Box like a week or so ago. I don't RTC afterwards. After I get in there and I see my opponent tech, I would always auto to nay. Now, granted, Titus missed the tech here, but I was probably out of rhythm. Also, like in this situation here, I'm already dashing. He is landing. I've already dashed back. Like, in the past, I would have preemptively gone and need this. Like, 9 times out of 10. Like, 9 times out of 10, I probably go and need this. It probably would have netted the stock here, in hindsight. But the fact that I'm not preemptive to doing it, it's progress. And I pick up on it. So this is fine. Even though, like, I mean, I just gotta keep knowing that a bit more. And get the stock off of it. Missed that. I just need to work on the JCs. I'm still not good at JC grabbing it on box. 1, 2. I probably could maybe run off up. I probably could. I may get the edge cancel jump squat thing if I miss it. Maybe a little bit too safe. I could have just like dash danced around and then done runoff up air, but no harm, no foul. I got the stock off of it. Titus did a really bad panic forward B.
Again. Gotta JC this. Actually, I'm curious now. If I let's grab startup here. Now I'm curious. 10 frame startup versus 6. So I lose 4 frames. Now let's think about this hypothetically here. Add a lag now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, okay, I'm already in fucking dash grab. So let's think about this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I literally lose this because I didn't JC grab. If I JC grab, I win this interaction. If I JC grab, I win this interaction by like 1 to 2 frames. That's super unfortunate. Okay, good humps attack. I like my defense. I mean, I really kind of had this game won, I'll be honest. I kind of had this game, definitely. Happens though. So I missed that. That sucks. My DI still needs to be worked on a lot on this thing. Titus is getting super desperate. That was a really bad forward smash, in my opinion. I'm definitely just looking for any sort of hit. I think I just gotta, like, I gotta slow down the pace, really. Like, because Titus, I'm still kind of letting him dictate the tempo. I need to just, like, let the tempo just, like, come to me. Like, there's no reason for me to really approach here, especially at this high percent. And he's, like, flailing and really, like, he's now finally starting to approach. Like, he's not doing dash back lasers anymore. That's, like, the biggest change I'm noticing. Like, let's see. Gets a punish. He still has not done it. He's not done it once. He's just going in. Or he's doing only that or in place. Like, there's not really any sort of dash back in this sort of scenario. And that's kind of the adjustment I'm noticing already. Yeah, after he lost that stock, he didn't dash back once. He didn't dash back laser once. Everything was hold forward. And that's just like, I finally got him like out of the dash back thing because he realized he needed to approach. Clipped him with the up air. Now in place. Two. That was really good, actually, on his part. But now I'm just curious. Because I missed a dash grab here. What I do, so knee. Did I waveline this? I'm curious now. I did waveline it and I got the tech, good tech. That was just a bad jump. Yeah, well, a lot of spaghetti. I could have probably back aired that. Like, probably not even just like a lot of stuff to go over. It's just kind of frantic melee and just really, really obvious drops. Caught my drop down. That was really good. Good, like 50. One. Can I need this? I'm curious. That was pretty decent DI. I couldn't have gotten it. Good dash back. He's not lasering. Or he at least, like, when he is lasering, he's not doing dash back. Yeah, so that was Tice's biggest adjustment already. Like, that's Tyus's biggest adjustment, is that he's either doing it in place or a slight fade in. That's the first one he's done. Okay, so he did one. Bad jump. Yeah. That was a really bad jump right here. Yeah, and then that's just me. I gotta remember not. Don't always full hop in the corner. Don't always full hop in the corner. Because, I mean, something like that can just get me exposed pretty bad. Damn, it took a fucking while for the next game to start. Game 2, Dreamland. If you're still watching this, Fallen, I am amazed. Because I overanalyze shit too much sometimes, at least in my opinion. I don't know. It's just how I analyze, but I appreciate if you're still watching. Or just listening. Because, I don't know. I ramble on sometimes about shit. Okay, that's an adjustment. Dashing back out of laser sun now. We got that. He did nair right here. Can I punch that in time? Maybe. I could have maybe punched that. In lag, in weight, probably not. The dash check was also a mistake, too. I did the knee thing again, but it worked out. Okay, well, I did some bad things and it worked out in my favor. I didn't turn on stomp this, but again, it worked. Yikes. Good shield. This is fine. Did I jump? Yes, I did jump. Okay, I'm kind of just brute forcing the interaction. Like, there's not really any reason, like, Falco's at zero here. This back air probably doesn't lead to really anything. Like, it's just there to get damage, and like, in a lot of ways, Tyus is kind of just waiting for me to get hit, waiting me to do something at this point. Like, it's a bit desperate. Like, instead, this is where it goes back to where I should. When Falco starts slowing down the pace, or like, chilling back in the back of that corner. Yeah, he's dashing back lasering now. Dash back lasering again. I don't know. I just like talking about certain interactions. Maybe it's just because, like, I started from Bob Money, who was an old school player. We did analysis a lot together. So, like, a lot of these sort of interactions, I would say it comes natural to me, but I just like talking about and, like, theory crafting what I could do better.
It's not easy to do, though. Like, it's definitely, like, an acquired taste. Really just, like, he starts repping Dashback Laser again. Now I just want to go back and see. I want to go back and see now on this first stock how many times he represents it. Okay, still not representing. Still not representing. Okay, so he's actually hidden it. Like, he's actually hidden it pretty well. So he stopped doing it and he started to keep the Dashback Laser fresh. But it is still a habit that he will do. Okay, that was kind of like a third that he did. Still playing fine. Nice. Missed the JC grab, but still, this is really good gameplay. Making it really hard for him to do anything. It's okay. Save your jump. This is good. Nice. This is all really good. And I got the way dash back to ledge. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. This is all fucking great defense. This is fucking awesome. So right after this, this is good. Roll away, that's fine. Dash back, nice. There's no reason to approach. There's no reason to approach. Lasers aren't going to do anything to you. And Tyus is not doing anything. Exactly. He is not committing. And this may have been the one big drop I had. Because I got dash grab instead. And again, that's just something that's going to come with time. Dash. And let's think about this real quick. So we're going to count JC grab. So that's 4 frames. So at the very maximum. Because grab comes out. I got to take into account 10 frames here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, fuck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, he may have buffered. He may have gotten a roll there. But again, that's fine. No harm, no foul. But it's something just keep in mind. I love the full hops here. This is all fine. It's okay if you lose the trade. I'm still alive. Like, this is probably, I mean, I would say, I would say one of the reasons I like going Dreamland here is that, like, you put more of the test on the Falco to kill you, and Falco Tunnel kicks in. Great, way dash back to ledge. I gotta work on the snap, like, way dash back to ledge snap. Did I refresh once? I did. Okay. Ooh, what did I do here? I shield. And he down airs. That's fine. Okay, he down airs and shines. What did I do? I tried rolling. Ah, shit. That sucks. I got the exposed part. Again, just missing it. The slap air grab is not even going to hit, though. Like, just no purpose behind that. It's probably anticipating that he'd be lower. He'd be lower and I'd be able to grab. That's probably why. But, no dice. Okay, this is good. Again? Yeah, I don't like this. I do not like this a lot. Don't act out quick enough. This is goes back to action out of wait frame one. Instead, I shield. There's no reason to shield. There's no reason to shield. You got the hit. You got the hit. There is no reason to shield.
If you get a hit, don't auto to shield. Plain and simple. Because that's my cue to be on offense. And what you do with offense, you go and push. That is not pushing. That is called stopping. Plain and simple. That is called stopping, and you fuck up. And I do a very, very... I mean, this is honestly just really bad at all levels. Like, there's no reason for me to dash in there. No reason for me to dash in there. And honestly, really hasty. Regardless if I was on control or a box, that's just really hasty of me to do. Can be a lot smarter than that. Like, even if I do hypothetically get this Nair here, I, like, at the position I'm at right now, because where am I when I shield here? Oh, that's, like, so fucking hard. Like, honestly. Like, right here. This is really fucking hard for anything to happen. Like, if I was, like, maybe closer to maybe, like, the very edge, where I'm, like, damn near teetering, I can maybe do, like, Nair drops on a knee or some shit like that, or maybe try the Nair into Rising Nair thing. But doing it at this range, it's just better if I just stay at center, honestly. It's just way better if I stay at center here. Because if I stay at center, I could just dash dance around and just wait for the down air lag and then grab him afterwards. Like, I have to take note of if I'm, like, around, like, the yellow flowers, there's no reason for me to commit. But if I'm around, like, the end of the fence on Dreamland, or, like, the end of, like, the flowers in the background, at least I think they're flowers, that's when I can throw in that option tree to maybe commit to something. Because if I'm right here, Falcon could do a lot of options. Like, I don't even think Downer happened to be the one that Titus chose, but he probably could have come down even with a Nair, and I probably would have been in trouble. Or even, like, a back air and reversal of the situation. It's just a bad spot I threw myself in. Yeah, let's see what I do. That's actually pretty good. This is really good by Titus. Like, all around. Like, waits out the invincibility and shield, that's fine. Full hop, this is such good abuse. I will say, I give Titus props, so this is pretty good use of full hop here. Because it's pretty much a full commitment if I were to even try and get him here. Like, I'd have to go so fucking high up to get him. And he goes immediately to ledge. This is really smart. Actually, I give a lot of props to Titus here. That was really smart. Because, I mean, like, what's Invincible Falcon going to do if Falco's just full hopping in the air and he's right on the ground? I mean, practically nothing. He'd have to call out his landing with, like, either a Nair to catch his landing. There's a platform right there, so that already makes it kind of difficult. And I try committing because I try to call that he's going to platform. That's my call. But he chooses not to. So this is just really good decision-making by Titus. And then I dash back, and I get caught. I think I was, like, caught in the air when he got the fucking deal up the laser. I was, and I could have at least held down this Nair. So, again, fuck me. Me having a bad CC game again. Gotta work on that. Gotta work on that. This is, like, I probably CC grab this instead. So, like, that part, this is good. I could have even acted out maybe laser stun, potentially, but either way, that was really good by Titus all around. Caught. I do the fade in there again. That's, like, a second or third time I've done it. Yeah, I don't even wait this time. I just fucking do it, and I get caught. Stop, that's fine. Even though it misses, I like that I'm trying it. Grab. That's just my RTCs being bad.
He gets a shine pickup. Tourney Winter Ring. Yeah, this is just, I'm kind of getting desperate here. I don't know how to ledge dash on box yet. That's something I'm still trying to learn. Still not that great at it. Let's see. Refresh one, get back on. That's also another thing. I like doing refresh one and then getting right back on. I usually just do one refresh and just jump back onto stage. Gotta mix it up a bit. And I think that can help when I get hack session led Josh, so. Don't just auto. 2-1 refresh. And aerial. Observe where opponent is and react accordingly. Because there are times where it's okay to do it. There are times where it's okay to one free pressure on and do it, but I need to remember observe more. Like, I definitely auto to that. It's definitely kind of like my autopilot. Don't. Observe and react accordingly. Okay, I got an 8th laser. That's fine. Biggest thing is I just don't have the tech skill yet. And I agree with what I said about I just don't have the tech skill yet. I certainly don't. Good dash back. This is fine. This nair is just from way too far of a range. It's a desperation nair. That nair is not going to hit anybody in a million years unless you're completely a scrub or new to the game. So, bleh. Good God. And Tyus SDs. Can't just get desperate. Gotta remember to RTC. Shine dinner. Jab. Yeah, okay, like, this is, I wouldn't say garbage time, but definitely just, like, try to fight something that works. Like, this is fine, dash dancing around. Looking for the stop, I don't fault myself for doing it. Yeah. And I die for it. Like, I think at this point, right, like, around, like, 3 stocks to 1, I think I was just looking for whatever could work. I wouldn't say I checked out, but I definitely was, like, getting desperate. This is good neutral. Good knee. Ah. I think it's this late. I could maybe dash dance this around. I don't fault myself for trying to go to the top there because I'm trying to get something started. But let's go back afterwards to when Tyus SDs. Was there anything? Yeah, bad nair. I catch it. Okay, so he just dies. And what's the rest of this neutral? Jumping around, that's fine. Okay, get a grab. Eat some really big damage. I just have to remember to DI away here. I think I'm panic DIing in because I just don't know what the fuck to do. I think it's just going to be, that's going to be the hardest thing is learn
to DI better on box. Now I'll just write combo in parentheses. Learn box combo DI. Dashing back here, let's see. It's fine, dashing back is fine. Get the narrow, not getting any trades. I'm narrowing from like halfway across the stage and it's just really telegraphed. Especially Tyus is just chilling here. He's starting to dash back laser again, so let's see. Dash back. Okay, he did it once. He's just lasering in place now. That's his adjustment. Laser in place, laser in place. And that's the set. So, I mean, that was his big adjustment, honestly. I think he did dash back laser, I think, only three, maybe four times that entire set. Which I think is actually super impressive that he made that adjustment. So... I don't even think I need to write that down for 12. I mean, I'll leave that as a question, maybe just like for me to think about. How to handle laser in place. But, I mean... now that I've broken down the set, and I'll say, like, it's... I'm kind of surprised that I'm not as far off as I think I am. Like, there's still a lot of ways to go, and I still think... If I'm going to surpass myself on controller, I'm going to give that, like, 1 to 2 years. But in terms of, like, where I'm at right now, I'm still pretty surprised that... I'm doing as well as I am, or getting like this close to even just like meeting somebody as Tyus, like who's pretty decent in their own right. And I'm already like having pretty respectable games with him, along with probably many, along with many others. Like, it's not a bad showing whatsoever. I don't think I played too bad this set. I think, like, you know, one thing that JC grabs, that's definitely number one priority. Same with the tech chases. I was able to hit some, but I definitely just need to, like, get that in my system more. I took note of the dashback lasers more. So, like, how is he doing at the lasers? In this case, it's going to be a dashback laser. He did that, like, 12 times in the first game. And his adjustment was laser in place the second game. CC slash ASD, I didn't come up real much, but it's just still something I know that I need to work on. And then, yeah, I mean, that's all I can really think about. So I guess I'll go back to my what to look for's here, which were, what is it? My what to look for's were, you know, hang on, why is my OBS like this? You know, where can my execution be polished up? I think it's a self-explanatory one. What habits do I still have regardless of controller? I think we easily found that with don't live and die by the fade in there out of shield, or overcorrect on the laser hit next interaction up, and then don't not auto shielding to something. So I definitely found, like, that's definitely a still habit I have regardless of controller. How to handle Falco lasers. Specifically in the corner, I mean, I think we also answered that just because Falco likes to Tyus like to dash back lasers. So in this case,
Take note of why they're where they're dash back lasering, and then either try to power shield it, side B it, or let the laser and see whether you add for the dash back laser. Because if he's not committing and he's just firing the gun, then what harm does it really do other than a couple chunks of percent?
Like, I think I just have to treat it at that point as, okay, I may take a couple hits or a couple damage, and that's it. And somebody like Titus may do it more. I know of players that will definitely try to do it more. Or there may be some people that just want to go in right and throw in aerials. And at least Titus, from what I saw in the set, was definitely down to shoot the gun a lot. At Anno Falco mix-ups, this is more just like an adaptability question, and I guess the mix-up or adjustment, if you will, was when Titus started, what is it? When Titus started doing laser in place instead of dashback laser, he only did dashback laser like 3 or 4 times in game two. And then what to do when Falco camps or slows down the pace or tempo? Just slow down to my tempo as well. I think plain and simple. Either that or try to close in the space or make them feel uncomfortable to where they're forced to approach or do something. Because there was that one stock I had that was really good on my end. I think it was in the first game. I made him really chase me well. But I think that's pretty good. And I think this is a good what we learned list as well. I'm really drained also. I did not expect to have 2 games turn into an hour and a half of film study, but it's just the nature of melee. Sometimes it do be like that. But I think that's it for my analysis for now. Thank you to anybody that tuned in and listened to me ramble for an hour and a half. I appreciate it, even though like people don't have to listen to it. I guess people don't have to listen to it. I don't know. I'm just a voice and a guy doing melee stuff. But 'twas fun, and thanks for tuning in, following in some of your input. In this case, I will peace for now. I may enter more Wild West Wednesdays or some shit. I don't know. Yeah, I should probably do this more for other matches. So, until then, peace.